Good evening and welcome back to Sunday Night Discipleship. We're glad that you're connecting with us again this evening, and we hope that you have had a wonderful day in the presence of God today. Tonight we are beginning a new series that I believe is very, very timely for the season that we find ourselves in. The series is simply called Unstuck, and it's available for viewing on Right Now Media. And as we've been talking about these last several Sunday evenings, if you do not have Right Now Media, we want to give you that resource for free. We want to put that into your hands. It is an amazing library of Bible studies and encouraging videos that we believe is going to bless your spiritual walk with the Lord. But getting back to Unstuck, the theme behind this series is simple: moving from the mundane to the meaningful. God has great things in store for us. And I realize this weekend, some of us might be kind of frustrated. Some of us might be feeling kind of down, as on Thursday, our governor announced new restrictions regarding the COVID-19 series. As we navigate this season, let's keep our hope and faith in Jesus Christ. These things that are happening are being done for our safety and for our benefit. I realize it's difficult as we are walking through this season to see the doors to our worship facility closed week after week after week. Believe you me, from a pastoral perspective, I would much rather be preaching to a sanctuary full of people instead of that single camera in the room. But I know that God is moving. I know that God is doing amazing things. I know that right now we are not stuck in a motionless position, but that God is on the move. And I want to encourage us today. And as we talk about this, listen, I know this is a changeup. I know that this season has been difficult, but God also told us in His Word that we would face such seasons, that there would be days of difficulty. In fact, when Jesus was talking to His disciples, and when He was expressing what it meant to be a follower of Jesus, He said this in Luke chapter 9, verse 23, "If anyone would come after Me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow Me." I would certainly say that we find ourselves in somewhat of a season of suffering. But church, can I tell you something? Our faith can somewhat be determined by our ability and willingness to suffer for the Lord. I want to encourage you in this season, as we move forward in faith, let us suffer well. Let us be that light that Christ has called us to be, no matter what mandate, no matter what regulation might come from our governing authorities. And again, I want to encourage us, we need to be praying for our government leaders in this season. We don't need to be rebelling. We don't need to be speaking words of negativity, but we need to be praying for those who are doing their best to lead our nation through this unprecedented time. But as a church, listen to me, we are not motionless. Just because this building that is behind me has been closed these last several weeks does not mean that God's Spirit is not on the move. Let's not get stuck in a position of negativity. Let's not get stuck in a mindset that is melancholy or that is joyless. Let me tell you, the joy of the Lord is our strength today, and we need to remember that, and we need to lean upon that. We have neighbors, we have friends, we have family that need to know Jesus' name. And God has called His church to be that light. God has called this body to be that shining example of His love, of His grace, and His truth right here in the Heartland. Last night in our board meeting, one of our leaders said it so awesomely, that even right now, as we're in this season of quarantine, that season of quarantine will never stop the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Jesus does not have to listen to a stay-at-home order. We know that we're living in the last days. We know that our window of opportunity to reach this world for the gospel is coming to a close. What are we going to do about that? Are we going to allow the enemy to try to get us stuck in a mindset that might seem mundane? Or will we allow the Spirit of God to propel us, to move us forward in this time? Even though suffering is a part of this, church, let's suffer well. And let's be that light that Christ has called us to be. There's another video that I would encourage you to watch. An individual by the name of Dick Brogdon gave this message at the Assemblies of God 100th birthday. We attended this sermon, we were there, and we were excited. The whole conference had been one of celebration, had been one of reflection of what God had done and dreaming of what God was doing. And then as we came to this closing rally, I had this expectation of this, again, more of the same, more celebratory, more giving this joyful noise unto the Lord. And then Dick Brogdon gave a message that pierced my soul, that pierced my heart. It was a message on suffering. He talked about how the last 100 years had been primarily years of blessing. And yes, God has blessed us tremendously, but I'll never forget in those moments, he talked about the way forward for the Assemblies of God was through suffering. And I'll be honest with you, in that moment, I didn't like those words. I'll be honest with you, in that moment, in fact, I wanted to reject those words. I wanted to go home that night and say, you know what? What is he thinking? There's no reason why we should have ended on that note. Well, listen to me, today I understand. Jesus made clear that as his return approaches, that what he called labor pains would increase. Church, listen to me. It doesn't matter the circumstances that are around us. Yes, they can be intense. And yes, they can cause us to struggle. But can I tell you something? They should also cause us to get on our knees and to believe for what God has in store. Let's not get stuck. Let's not get set in a mindset and sit back and just kind of ho-hum through this season. This is a season of opportunity to be the light that Jesus has called us to be. And when that day comes that we're able to open the doors to this worship facility again, church, we are believing for faces and families who have never been here before to flood this place in response to the life change they have experienced in Jesus Christ. I hope that you'll tune in for session one of Unstuck on Right Now Media. I hope that you'll watch that message from Dick Brogdon. Look for the link to that message in the Facebook broadcast. And there you will be, and I promise you this, be ready to be challenged, but also be ready to be encouraged. Because no matter the amount of suffering we may face on this earth, if we have Jesus, we have all that we need. God bless you. We look forward to connecting with you on Right Now Media for session one of Unstuck.